All right. Very good evening. Welcome to this discussion tonight on Queensville. This is not a Queensville event. This is actually something different than on the Queensville that I'm having to go by. First of all, my name is Tez, obviously. I run Queensville on YouTube. Tonight on on the special event, this is a discussion about Magic 1152 and Boar Media. And people have been annoyed at the fact that Magic 1152 has lost all its viewers and all its listeners as well. I've been listening to Magic 1152 for over 2 years now, and I love the station so much with the music, the great interaction, and it was great. It's a great radio station that was part of the Northeast and everywhere else that was going on. So tonight, what I'm going to do tonight is Trace, I can't remember her name now on here, but I've got a chat room open live here on Google+, and I want to say a very good evening to Casey Tidy, by the way. Hello. And I've also got a live link as well on the page of the Magic 1152 live page as well. This is going out live on YouTube tonight. And I've got my laptop here because I'm looking at the comments, by the way. Jane Portree runs this page on Facebook for over a month now. 2 months, 2 weeks she's been running it for over since it actually changed hands. And if you have been listening to the new stations that have been going on all around the Northeast, I'll explain about that in a minute. But one thing that I want to address on this video, Magic 1152 was a brilliant station and was still, to this day, awesome. With presenters, which you can see on the screen, which obviously we had Dave Campbell, Nick Wright, Ray Rose, Anna Foster, Tom Davies, and the many people in the world of radio who have now moved on. Now, as I understand, people are petitioning so hard to get Magic back on the air. Now, I've literally, for the past 2 weeks, have been eye-glued very much into this page. Jane has done a good job of this as well, and you've got supported. Now, today was a very interesting thing. People have now got an email address to send emails to the following two people for Boar Media. Now, this is really interesting. The only thing about this is that when you email them, you have to give a good reason why you want Magic back. Okay? Now, as I said before, the presenters at the moment have left on to go on with other things now, when I know where they are. Now, as I understand, Dave Campbell, who is here, he's now working on Lancashire Radio, and he's also working with Boar Media as well at the time that this is just going out. Anna Foster's obviously moved to Maiden Town and Weir, which is based at Sunderland Campus in Sunderland, so she's there now. And she's also doing a lot more presenting in that style of it as well. What I can't understand is, this is how things have grasped for me a little bit. This is what we don't like. Ray Rose and Nick Wright are now the owners of Magic 1152, or Your Music 2, or what I'd say is Metro Radio 2. Now, everybody is absolutely disgusted about everything going on with Magic 1152. Now, I'd say my own point of view, because I know everything about the radio side of stuff, right? This petition has been going on for over two weeks now, and when it started, I had to subscribe to it because it was so very important. Now, the other thing is that, as I understand, that other presenters are still in live radio, and as for this week, Dave Campbell is on Lancashire Radio. Anna Foster is still doing her bits for the Maiden Town and Weir. Ray Rose and Nick Wright say they're part of the station and they want to make our music so well. The new music on that station doesn't work, I'm sorry to say. I don't understand how you can scrap your 60s show, your pop quiz, and then after that, you play new stuff that our listeners are not liking because the listeners don't like it. And I think, from my own personal side, because I do a radio show myself, which was Rock Show Live. I did it for over 5 years. Now, what I can't understand is why Boar Media is wanting to scrap everything from the Magic side and bring in this new thing, or we think popular. No, Canada is losing a little bit of the audience side. So, this week, I trailed around every radio station, and every station played the same stuff every hour. And this is where everybody on Facebook has gone potty with this, because this has just gone amazingly well. So, I'll get the comments later. That's going to be something I'm going to talk about in a minute. You can comment live here on the Queensville page, which is here, which is on the side here on the screen. And you can also get into the chat room tonight as well. Comments, I'm going to get to them later, but I'm going to talk about basically how Magic has left and what's going on. Right, now, as I understand, the reason that Magic has finished was to drop the name. It wasn't to drop the radio stations, it was to drop the name. Because now it's got the Your Music International Board Media. It's just got a new policy out where from the 5th of January, we were all going to go into the world of the kids' music, you know, the new music and the music that we sort of don't like. There's not one station ever in the Northeast, anywhere at all, that now will tell you to tune into your music station, right? Nothing of the 60s, nothing of everything else. They scrapped the 60s and now Ray Rose and Dave Campbell, Ray Rose and Nick Wright want to now concentrate on the new music side, right? Never ever in 5 years ever heard a station play anything new, anything classic. There's no classic rock. There's basically nothing on any of the new stations that I think we have nothing of. So we have nothing of Magic's side that is not brought back to the radio stations in the Northeast. We've lost it all. The community is not very happy with this. And obviously everybody's now going to email to the two people who are heads of Board Media. Now, I've pretty much been glued to the site on Facebook a lot. And Jane's doing an amazing job of keeping this going up. And everybody said Magic should come back. And I agree. I totally agree with it. I think Magic shouldn't have dropped. I think Magic should have stayed on the air. It should have continued to have been a station that would have identified itself as being in the 60s, more of the music morning shows with Nick Wright, the evening shows with Ray Rose, which everybody loved that show so much because he was at the pub all the times, not as such. Then we had the best show ever on Magic, which was Anna Foster. And Anna Foster was just brilliant. In the morning, we never had a show like that ever, ever. For the breakfast shows from 6 till 10, it was, for me, one of the highlights of the whole lot. And my camera's got a bit weird as well. Why is that? Just a moment, folks. Just get sorted out. Can't comment that tonight, live. Let's chat, by the way. I'm just getting the camera sorted out because my camera's gone funny. Go on, put my paper up, obviously. But the main thing about it is that I love that station so much because I really want to back it up. This is the station that should stay. It should never, ever, ever leave. You know, we want it back. So we are all petitioning to get this radio station back on the air because without Magic, there would be no more music. There wouldn't be any comedy side of Dave Campbell. And his brilliant shows that came on, Dave Campbell's was absolutely brilliant. And Dave Campbell's was really the best one of the lot because he gave us great afternoons and funniness and craziness and everything else. And he is still, to this day, one of the best presenters ever. He's still active, though, on the Board Media Network, but he's moving on to something else, which is kind of where he's heading to it now on it, which is one thing. But from our point of view, here we come to the interesting bit now. Now, as we all know, we've all tried our hardest to do something about it. Board Media do not listen to anybody. Board Media doesn't do anything. They are just arseholes. Their critics are bad. The music's not good because everyone's the old music back and the old stream was great. Golden Years is gone. Yeah. And then we had like this other stuff going on from like the pop quiz and which was great. But now they don't take any calls on air. We don't have Bar Balloons anymore. We don't have our friends that were on there. James, what was he? What's that guy's name? James Bond 101 or something? And so he should have basically have stayed. So here's my overview of Nick Wright. Nick Wright, the owner of the station. Yes, Nick Wright was the owner of Magical M52. He was the guy who Richie brought it from Cleveland. Then it came on to Newcastle, and then it went from Newcastle to Manchester, because that's where everybody's gone now. So Nick's now gone from the Newcastle one over to Manchester. So is Ray. He's gone to Manchester as well. The other two people, Dave and Anna, we miss them. It's a shame she had to go, but it was her decision. She wanted to leave because she didn't want to play the old music on the show. Until the Dave as well, he had the same thing and he left as well. The week he handed his notice in, he knew for a fact there was just something going wrong with it. So the final broadcast on Christmas, before Christmas, was pretty sad. But we love that dude. We love that dude so much. And Dave Campbell should do his own show somewhere. But it'd be good for it as well. So I think we need Magic back. We need the station back. The station has to come back with an identity. It was excellent music it had in the 60s. It was brilliant. Everybody loved the music so well. New stuff, I wasn't keen on the new stuff, but saying that, if it had more rock orientated and classic rock and classic 60s on it, that would work out fine for it. I think it would have worked out well. So that's what I think that I'm basically pleading out so much, because I want the station to come back, because we miss the station so much. As for the other stations, like the Your Music category, that is nothing that I don't like. I'm obviously into Queen, I'm into Mormon Rock in the 60s, and everything else I just love so much, because seriously, that's where it's basically they, Bull Media went upside down and they went the other way. They didn't go that way and go down. It went down. The figures for the Bull Media sector were, Magic came out actually as the best station of the year. And it was. From what I understand, I think Bull Media's done it wrong. They haven't, I think they've rushed it fast basically. They've decided, what we like to do is we like to just play new music. We'll have some, what can we think of? Let's have some Celine Dion, Bee Gees. Let's have some new dance stuff. That's not for me, that. But I've not seen that station change since it was on the air. So here's an idea for you guys tonight on this special thing. If you want to contact them, here's the two addresses I'm going to put on the screen. First of all, this is a guy. This guy here is in charge of all of the stations on Bull Media. Now, this guy, you should email this guy. Tell him that you are seriously not happy with everything on their network. Okay, you should basically go to this address here, email the guy. People are trying to send him 3 emails a day to get it in their heads that this is wrong. And this is just basically upside down, all the way around, and not even right. And I'm seriously not very happy with the Magic at all, with the new stations. James Grover, boardmedia.co.uk. Guys, email this guy. Tell him everything that's gone wrong. I've emailed him today. I'll show him my email in a minute as well. That I've sent them. If you didn't get to see it, I'll show you in a minute as well for us. I'll also, we'll give you another email address as well, which is going to be d.ford@boardmedia.co.uk. Now, she's also the programming director of Board Media Limited. And so if you guys want to be involved in this tonight, get in the chat room tonight and let's have a good chat about this, because we need it back. Because I miss it. I don't have anything to listen to now. I mean, I'm all into What I consider it as being is I'm more into rock, metal, classic 60s, 70s, 80s. Everybody tuned at different stations and they all said this is nothing. This is just total crap. So we need the station back. We need a petition this so well. So Jane has to do her hardest work. Maybe people who petition to get it back, send it to these two guys here. I'll keep this on the screen all night for this as well. But what we're going to do, we're going to get the comments now on the page, and we're going to say to Casey Tidy. Good evening. She says, this is actually Carol Moore, so don't understand why it's my granddaughter's name up here. Okay, that's fine. He says, hi, maybe you've... Oh, no problem. I'm your admin, Maria, who has gone as far as to get this group set up, which is for listeners to magic, to the posted music they loved. Yes, this is absolutely right. I totally agree with that, actually, Maria. Jane says, I'm Jamie Hines back, Magic Adventure 2, and Magic Memories go along with my lifetime friend, Maria, and we are the supporters for this site. We need a site, basically, to go ahead, to get these guys to talk about this, because what I miss about it, I miss the competitions. I miss also the fact that we don't have a chance to email the guys. No emails are read out. They've also complained about so many adverts on the radio station. Nick Wright has not got time to go through emails. He's only got 3 hours on the show to do. Ray Rose's show is getting there, but people are losing a little bit of touch on that show a little bit because it's not the same as it was before. Tom Davies, who was also on Magic, he has also said that this, that everybody said that it's they've complained about it because the show is boring. What I just could not get around my brain was John Leslie. John Leslie is on friggin' Mad, is on the new station on Metro Radio 2. No, that's totally wrong because nobody listens to it and I think this show sucks. So that's what I think anyway. But I have to say, bottom of my heart, I miss this station so much. And we've got to get these guys back. Dave Campbell, we've got to get this guy back. Dave Campbell. Get him on another station. So good for that. And I really want to say that I really want to wish that this station was back because I'm missing this station so much and this is part of my home. This is some Newcastle was where they should have stayed. They should have stayed there. They should have stayed in the studio. It was great to be there because I saw Anna Foster. I actually met Anna Foster on... I was actually live on the radio as well. So you might have heard me on the radio before when I was actually on Magic 952. And I went in the studios actually and I loved it. I really loved that station. It was so homey. It was so warm. Everything was great. And then it was like Nick Wright going, yeah. It was just his walk. It was just good. But no. Say on a serious note, there's no other stations that I can't think of at the minute. I can't think of any of the stations that we have because there's about probably now half of the network has gone way down. It's now orientated to kids for some reason. So why is Nick Wright playing kids music on a station that is lost touch, right? Because all teenagers, all this rubbish now, and it's totally not right. Even the playlist, when he posted on the playlist bit, well, what was on it? Rubbish kids stuff. That's nothing what I don't want to see from that anyway. I want this back. Why should go back to the original format as it was? Because that was just pants when I heard it. It's terrible. Let's see what Maria's saying. Yeah, thank you. Thanks for this. Magic was bought, magic and bored media have bit themselves on the arse. Folk are turning off in droves. Cuts in program length. The players is crap. We want Magic back as if it was cut across all age groups. It should be all age groups. If I'm 39 and as I understand, Magic was just brilliant. It was just really good. I mean, but when I think what happened was they changed all of the I think what happened is they changed all the idents, which worked all right, but when they changed the voiceovers on the items, it just didn't. I was like, well, what happened to Mark Thorburn? What happened to him? Because he was brilliant when he came on. But what I really just detest is when they decide to change everything over. And I was like, oh my God, I can't stand this stuff. It's like, no way. I can't sort of like really get my head around the new concept thing. And all of a sudden it's like, yeah, we kind of got the idea, but that's what we want to try and focus on is new music side. So all they've done, Bore Media has done, is they've screwed us over. All this rubbish about new music coming in, old music coming out. And all of a sudden it now goes backwards and forwards. It's like a ticking time bomb. It's their loss. They should never have changed it. You should never have changed it. You should have kept it exactly as it was. Because now, as I understand, I think Jane's website, Jane has said she's very annoyed that they didn't change the format and they want it back. She started this petition on very well. I do urge you guys to go and email these two guys though, James Grove and Dee Ford at Ball Media. Give them your opinions about it. The better we get through with these guys, the better emails we get received from them, the better chances Magic gets back on the air. And then all the studios back together, Newcastle's back there, Anna will come back, Dave will come back. But what it mains down to is Nick Wright. He's the guy who changed all the rules. Because Nick Wright and Ray Rose, they were the two guys who changed it all. And I sent them an email over the last 2 weeks ago, and I got a reply back from them. And they said, and that's no bullshit, they said to me, we are changing the station a little bit because it's gone to other hands now of your music station. And Nick and I are the proprietors of the station now. It's basically down to Nick and Ray. Those are two people who started it up. This is all started by Nick and Ray. It's not Bond Media. It is, kind of. But it's actually Nick and Ray. They started it. Bring it back. Because we just think it's all rubbish. Anyway, so if you want to be involved in this brilliant chat tonight of Bring Back Magic 1152, be involved tonight, please, because I'm getting loads of messages from people in it. Casey Taney is saying, no, actually it says, Jane's saying, Carol Moore from Salford, thank you for tuning in. She says, otherwise known on the Ian Roberts show as a dynamic duo, the other half being Shirley Smethurst. Listen every morning, Goss getting ready for work. His show was great. Ian, what's his name again? Ian Roberts. Fabulous guy, him. I listened to his show probably once, I think, and then a few nights for that. It's great. Anna Foster's show, awesome show. Bring it back, please. Need it back. It says Magic goes around about 1979 before that was GNR, correct. GNR was brilliant. Most of the programme was done from London, actually, from BBC. It's all we want to know, and what the hell is benefit is brief at young and the old disabled, the household have all behind by Board Media. That's totally right, Jane. I totally agree. Totally agree with that. They should never have changed any of the info. They should never have changed it all. It should have stayed. Magic should have stayed. Karen Tracy. Then listen at work at 10 till the quizzes. Love listener participation. They broke up on air. Family. Miss Ian, all your listeners cried when Ian finished his show. I was upset when Dave Campbell finished his show. But don't forget, guys, he's actually going to be on Radio Lancashire Monday and Tuesday. He's actually playing 60s and 70s next week, and his 80s is back. So that's a good idea. So that's cool. So try that station next week. See if you can think about that. Maria's saying, no interaction at all. Nick is reduced to 30 seconds chat between chat. Ray gives us a very educational electric selection of music. Yeah, I've noticed that. Tom was brilliant. Tom Davies was awesome. Tom Davies was just brilliant. He knew everything about everything. Good guy. He says, Tom was brilliant with yours. Bob was to sit up and take notes. Folk are turning off, apart from when our lads are on. Kids download from Spotify. I do agree with that as well. They do. They don't listen to any radio, it's just the Magic audience. They're into downloads, but every age group in my family, friends, etc. appreciated Magic and the brilliant presenters. I do agree. I have to say, I will totally agree with that, Maria, that they have lost out. The kids today listen to R&B rubbish. We don't have any of that. We don't have any of our classic music, as on our brilliant rock stuff like Badminton Overdrive. We don't have any of that brilliant stuff like How's That from, just play bloody constantly over and over and over again for like 3 months or so, which is just getting on my bloody nerves. But it's okay with station repeaters on music, but saying that though, it goes over the top a little bit. But they could have improved it a bit better if the music was a little bit changed a bit on it, which I did say to Nick many times, change the music a little bit, mate, because if you over repeat yourself so much, it won't get out to the public. That's what thrust it. As for like the other stuff, like you've got Ray Rolls and stuff. I mean, Ray Rolls' show, his show's okay. It actually was great when he did it on Magic, because it was fun. It was great at night time. You could listen to him. You could send him an email. You could even get email read out. You could tell him what your day was like, what your music was into. He was brilliant. But he looked awesome now, which is a shame. Sorry, I'm in a 30-minute chat between tracks. I've heard his show. I heard one day of his show for an hour. I turned it off because it was just crap. It was crap. So I haven't seen the decent station we have of these anyway. Cry when Ian finished his final show with the words, "I'm going to miss you all." Well, it was a very sad moment, and hundreds of listeners. I'm now listening to Radio Manchester. Yeah, Radio Manchester's okay. Right, keep your. Well, I'll take these last. I'll use two more. Keep them coming in. Keep your chats going. Trey Casey's saying, "I will follow Ian Roberts on his Facebook page and look forward to the day when he starts broadcasting again and the on-air family is reunited." That's what I want to hear. That's great. And Jane's saying, "If they want us to only tune in when Nick and Ray and Keith are on, we will turn off Metro 2 until the boys have come back." I agree with that. I think what kind of puts it off, if you love a station that played all this stuff from everything they did, you would never believe that it was just a station that was identified. You could listen to it anywhere in the car. Vicky Archer's show was recorded. It wasn't live, actually. Vicky Archer's show was never, ever live. And neither was Steve Phillips' show. Never live. Recorded it at home. So that's why. He's thinking, well, I didn't know that. Yes, it was two of them shows. And the Saturday shows done by Dave Campbell were recorded as well on the afternoons. And also Nick Wright's show on a Saturday were recorded as well. So those were recorded in the afternoons. Because they weren't there at the station at the time. They recorded them during the mornings and stuff at the second studio in Newcastle. So, and that was it really. And all of the early show with Anna Foster that was on Magic, that was actually the best of the lot. She was great. She was really good. It was cool. But I do agree with Jane and with Maria. I do have to say, I have to agree with everybody on this chat tonight that we do need a back, and it is so important as well. Anyway, today I've sent an email to Ball Media today, and I'll show you on my camera now what I showed them. This is the email I sent today with them, and I'll try and read it as best as I can because it's pretty small. This is the email I sent today to James at grove.beballmedia.co.uk. I sent him, I'm disappointed in the way that Magic 92 is finished and the stations that you're running is not what the audience is wanting to hear. It's correct. Why change the stations from the classic 60s to the 80s and then decide that due to the changes in policy, Ball Media will have to change its new policy from 2015? I listened to a week of broadcast, and it's a shame that we lost the listeners, didn't get a chance to respond. When listeners have Magic 952 as the best station in 2014, it's now really annoying as we have to listen to awful, terrible DJs. When now you got rid of the best presenters, Anna Foster, Dave Campbell, sure, the changes have improved. Nope, you've lost a lot of listeners. And in my opinion, in response to this email, everyone on petition, bring back Imagine 1152, which Jane has done. She said, "We disputed this as the worst turnover in the whole Ball Media industry. Either this is to make things better for the community, airwaves, or either you've not taken our opinion seriously. I wish we had our stations back to what it was. Sure, this is a way of scrapping off the back burner to make ways for the other stations to be more radio commercial, free listening to the public's ears." No, I don't think so. Nope, you've lost listeners, and our true radio listeners won't want our stations to continue and bring people back. If Dave Campbell is now broadcasting on his wavelength, he is Campbell approved. This is what I've put in, okay? The best one they've ever had. Now that he's suspended or been subjected to play rubbish music for the kids, is overrated. It's really bad. Well, I must say, this is a disaster from the 5th of January. I'm not happy with these changes. They should be back the way they were originally. We protest the officers and have our say. I look forward to your reply. That's my email I sent today to Ball Media. Now, if you've got an email you would like to send them, send them to these two addresses here on the screen, james.grove@bullmedia.co.uk. He is the manager. Programming director is dford@bullmedia.co.uk. These two guys, if we get as many petitions in as possible to do this, then I'm going to back up Jane on her page. The many petitions that they receive, the better chances this station can get back on the air. And don't you worry. I'm still going to put my say about this. Without this tonight, we need to tell them that this is important. My Scrap the Station was brilliant. It was all networked together. We were a family. We were magic. It was brilliant. But then go off and say, oh, that's rubbish. Crap. Anyway, more comments coming in. Let's see. If they want us to tune in, oh, sorry, Howard Card says, as the saying goes, why try to fix something that isn't broke? Well, that's Bull Media's fault. That's Bull Media's penny-ass thing anyway. I recently posted the figures on Jane's thing, and I said to her, these are the figures that were from last year. Magic came out actually as their best. 880,000 listeners, I think it was. But the figures for January, I think they're going to be sucking arse. I think they're going to lose them. The changes are just bad. They are not. The changes are, I think, right. They are seriously... Either they're wanting to really, really say that we're here to bring you new music to the variety of the stations we want to play, but not from the category side of how we interpreted being as radio friendly. Right. So you've got none of, so as I said before, you've got nothing of Badminton Overdrive, you've got nothing of Bo Skaggs, Needle Shuffle, never gets played. You've got Casey the Sunshine Band, never gets played. You've got Shalimar, never gets played. You've got ELO, but it's gone. You've got a Pretty Woman, played every bloody morning. What I don't understand is how they've done. I mean, this is just really silly because what I think Bournemouth was trying to do, what Bournemouth is trying to do, they're trying to lose listeners from the classic people from the 30s to the 50s age group. And all of a sudden now they want to say, right, well, we're not interested in that. We want to go back to, we want to go backwards to the new music, but it doesn't work for us. So it proves a point, though. It proves a point that you think, If your music comes in as we think popular, woo, right? No, you're not thinking. We think popular. That's a slogan you just made up yourselves. We think popular is we think pop music works. Rock music is crap. They're doing this because the fact is the kids like this more better than the adults do. So they really are having to really think, we will make sure that Magic 1152 is to stay. It should have been as it was. That's my own opinion about it. That's my own popular positive opinion about it. If Magic 1152 comes back, let them come back. If not, well, that's down to Bull Media. So email them and tell them your petition sucks. Because the other thing you'd be telling them is probably saying to them, well, Jane's backed us up very well because Jane's part of this thing. This petition has been slaughtering me up so much. I want things to say about this. So have you say about it, guys. I mean, 5 people have emailed the guys already this morning, and well done, because if we get more petitions in to keep the station, to save the station, to get it back on the air, get it back on the air, because this is really going to be good for us all. Because we miss everybody here was a family. This family should never have left. I think we just from my own point of view, the first time I listened to Magic was probably 2 years ago in 2013. And after listening to that station, I loved it. I think it was great. And also you had the brilliant presenters that came on for relief purposes was that guy from Viking 2 he was on, who was doing the, who was taking, because obviously when Dave was away, he was replaced by a few other people. One of the people who I don't really like on I really don't, I gripe a lot, is John Kane. John Kane's not, he's all right, but he's very slow presenting-wise. He isn't the best presenter, I should say that. But Tom Davies, I like that guy. But Dave Campbell, he is still going okay. He is the best guy. He was brilliant. Nick Wright. If he is the guy who's responsible for all these changes on board media, why the hell change it for? Why? It's ridiculous. I mean, the guy's what, 40 odd? Or 30 odd or something? 20 odd? I don't know how old he is. But if Nick Wright never changed anything on the station would have stayed. Was a safe disgrace. But I, in my own opinion, if you are wanting to change a music station to a station that you want to save or keep, don't change Magic. No, don't change it. It's nothing. If they can't, if we out there send about 5 emails a day to these two guys and 2 to Nick Wright as well, tell him you want it back. But he would just say no. Get an email and go no. Didn't want it. Not interested. So if you've got something to say about this tonight, say something about it. What was your best part of Magic? What was the most best part of the shows? What was the amazing part of it? The best part, I would say, was a pop quiz. I actually took that idea from when I did my own pop quiz on this channel. And I have to say that I think that was the best one of the lot. So it was really amazing. So I'll say from a point of view, I will be keeping an eye on this thing. It's Magic 952 business going on. But if Jane decides to keep this going, and also Maria, is it Maria and Jane or somebody else, keep it going, because we want the station back. We just miss it so much. I just don't know what it was. It was just that station was, there was a lot of stuff about it that was, you could have just basically have got a bed with it. You could have listened to it. Vicky Archer was there doing a marriage counselling on there, which was kind of a bit mischievous in a way. And Dave Campbell, as I say, we just miss this guy. So we miss him a lot. So I have to say my own opinion, this should be brought out as an exception to board media. So here's a message to board media. Board media, don't change your policy. Get back to the original sort of, bring back Magic for the Northeast. Stick to your other stuff and your own ways. Email these guys, after the show's over, email these guys, tell them. Anyway, got more coming in. Peter, hello Peter. A Magic was shortchanged. John has 3 hours of 60s Magic. Nick has 3 hours of 70s Magic. But only Dave has 2 hours of 80s Magic. That was on the weekend. That was on the Saturday. As I understand, the Dave Campbell show was recorded on the Saturday. It wasn't live. For 2 hours. From 4 till 6 it was. He had the 80s show. Awesome 80s show, it was a really good show as it was. Then you had Nick's show, which was 70s Magic on a Saturday. His was on from 1 until 4. And then, was it 1 till 3? I can't remember what time it was on now. But Nick's show was really good, the 70s one was good. John Kane's show was alright, but it was a bit boring in a way. And obviously, John had 3 hours of 60s Magic on the Sunday, which I never saw that show, because his show was alright, but it just got a bit really, he didn't know what he was doing, he was all like sort of muddled up words and things of his own side. He's a good presenter though, but saying that, it's okay, but it's fine anyway. If you all want to go and petition after the show, keep it going on the Magic Bring Back Magic 1152 on the site, and please bring it back. But do send your emails to these two guys here. These are two guys. Send a message to Nick Wright as well at Your Music 2. I think it's always at Magic Radio 11, or is it Metro Radio 2.com? I think it's that one. If someone can find out his email address, then get his email address sent. I did send an email to him anyway by Ball Media, and I have got his email somewhere, so I will post that on the page. If you want to email Nick Wright, email him. Tell him. The stations don't work. So I do say one thing. Next week, guys, don't listen to any more of this. Don't listen to any more of this new one, because it's not going to work. Find a station that's a little bit similar to this. If not, I'll start one up, because I can. And if we don't get magic back, I'll do something about it. I'll go to their offices in Newcastle and I'll tell them, and I'll knock on the doors and I'll say to them, why did you change all these changes at Ball Media? Your station's there, but we're not getting what we can. So if anybody's with me to go down to their offices and protest about this, do it. Because I think this is something that they need to say about it. And don't you worry, I'll say something about it as well. Because I think we've lost it all. Gene Bilton, hello. I miss the daytime presenters for their banter. Great. I wish it was like that when they were talking to us, not at all. I certainly can't stand the daytime presenters now, and certainly will not listen to John Leslie. I've been talking about John Leslie as well, and I'll also be safe on my channel, because this is the channel I run. I don't like his show at all. The first 5 minutes of his show were just so crap. So I don't like his talk. And I don't even like his show anyway, so I won't be listening to him. Because everybody knows about that controversy he had before, and that was it. Another thing as well that Magic used to do, I'll tell you in a second. The other one, DLT show, was terminated from Magic because of the scandal he had with that. And then there was the other thing that happened. DLT show got... David Travis's show got thingied off. Then it was Mike Reed's show is still going on, but he broadcasts from down at Berkshire, BBC Berkshire. He does. So here's something I'll give to Jean and to Jane and everybody here who's watching this live stream. Try BBC Berkshire, because Anne Diamond's on there as well, and even Mike Reed's on there, and Tony Blackburn's on there as well. So try BBC Berkshire. And I tell you what, when you listen to BBC Berkshire in the morning, let me know what it's like. Because I think it might be better than what you listen to now, actually. But if you can find a station that has any of these guys on, I know next week, obviously, Dave Campbell is still broadcasting next week on his show. And his show was brilliant this afternoon. Brilliant. Really good. So BBC Berkshire, try that one indeed. Matt Ray is sending them a message. Says 3 hour shows are no good to Nick or Ray when they have so much to give. Competitions, listener, partitioner, patient. Competitions. What competitions were Magic running? What? None. Listener, partitioner, 60s at 6, 70s at 7, and 2 hours of Magic from Mix at Ray at after 8. Tom was a joy. Dave was brilliant. Dave is the fucking dude. He's the best. We need him back. Exactly the same winning order, especially the same hours, exactly the same times, and the sort of music we played for all the years of Magic was doing. You know, Maria, I have to say, you've basically said exactly what I've said there. That's exactly what we should have. We should have this back, because without these guys, we would not have had a radio station that would have been committed to play music and to really be outstandingly the best ever network radio station that we ever had. But we have to succeed. We must succeed on this. We've got to have succeeding on this thing. Nick used to do the initial letter just a bit of fun. I know he did. If Nick Wright didn't change all the changes at Magic, at Boar Media, why the hell give a job to Nick and Ray to say, because I bet you Nick said to him, hi Ray, do you fancy running the new station for me now? And he's saying, yeah, fine, let's have a bit of a smoke. So what are we going to do about this new magic in MV2? Yeah, let's drop the name. This is exactly what he would do. It seriously is just ridiculous, because I don't understand how... I mean, all right, one thing is, the AM radio frequency has finished now, actually. It's ceased. You can't get it on there now. You can't get on DAB. So it was kind of a bit shit. And then it was like, well, okay. Jane says, Rover's head of music in Magic now. He's not. He has to play what they say has to be played. Ooh, smack on the hand for him, then that's bad. Well, here's what I think, right? In fact, you're wrong. Jane, actually wrong. Dave Campbell was head of music. He was. It was not Nick. It wasn't Ray Rose. It was actually Dave Campbell. Dave Campbell was head of music originally. And he had the final say about it, because he had his own way about it. And if you look onto a website, it tells you the profiles. Because it was him. It was not him, actually. He says, count me in. I'll live in Newcastle. Let's pay a visit to them. You know what? I've got the number. You know, I've got the phone number. All I've got to do is knock on the door and just pull the buzzer and say hello, Magic MV2. Hello. We just talk to you about this new changes of Magic MV2. You've got to go and press a button at the corner. The corner is right, and say, this is Magic MV2. Can we have a little chat with you guys about the new changes of Boar Media, please? Why change everybody? Why sack everybody? Why move everybody? In fact, I'll tell you what it was. When I went there, the studios were small. Like, if you see the picture of Dave Campbell on his page, he had the picture of the station. I think he's still got his page. That was actual little studio there was, because there was a studio next to that one, where they did all the recordings in there, and then there was a third studio in the back, which was the radio, which was the news studio. I didn't do all the news, so that was some news. Let's see. Maria says, "Born mistake, they must stick their own nose in and accept us to be happy." John Leslie. Who you doing? Hi, you cry for me? Oh, okay. Yeah, you haven't laughed. Leslie has so much pizzazz on snout. that's just ridiculous. It says, or stand corrected. Oh, it wasn't Ray Rose. It was Dave Campbell. Yeah, it was Dave Campbell who was doing all the music program inside of it. Ray Rose had his own playlist to play on the station, but Dave ran all of the music on there, which he was the best guy who have done that. I'm drinking cherry because I'm so thirsty. Anyway. So that's from Jean and from Jane. Maria, if anybody else wants to comment about Magic MV2 tonight, please do, because I'm loving this chat tonight. If you guys want to email the guys after this broadcast is over, email addresses are on the screen. I'll put the email addresses also on this video as well. And if you guys would like me to follow this up, we will follow this up on the next video. If you want me to do it, I'll do it, because I want this station to come back. Because I used to love going downstairs, turn the radio on, Ray Rose would be on with his 60s, and even better, make the tea. And you could just basically email them, have a Kindle there, just Kindle. It was brilliant. Now, Boar Media thinks, oh, yeah, well, we're not going to change it now. We're just going to scrap it all. You've all got your jobs online now. Sack you all. Ridiculous. Very pansy, aren't they? Just because it's changed the music scene, now I'm going to say, oh no, we'll change it to all the... Can we listen to the kids' sounds now? Stupid people. I listened to Magic Limp 61. Limp 61 was good. The Durham one was good as well. Magic Limp 70. Until it was finished. Because Limp 70 was was Durham, Wearside, Durham, Darlington and York, I think it was. I think it was that one, because it was networked anyway. All of them was networked together on that. But I do have to say, though, that they are being, ageist. I will get a chance to put something towards Gene, though. You're right. They're being stupid. Jane says, the whole of the Northeast is bereft, and we have to do this. We will not stand to lose our heritage. We've got to do this. We've got to go down. We've got to protest, and we've got to tell them, get Magic back on the air. You should have changed it all. I can just see, right, the next month, the end of January, on the 1st of February, when the new figures come in, you watch, right, and I bet you Metro Radio 2 figures will go down. They will. Somebody doesn't want to listen anymore. But it's not broadcasting from Newcastle anyway. It's broadcasting from Manchester now. So why the hell you scrap that studio and also now you're moving them down to Manchester? I don't understand it. Does he live there or something? I mean, Dave Cameron lives in Dunstan. He lives in Newcastle. He lives in Dunstan way, so he lives there. You can keep tweeting him, by the way. It's a Twitter page of him, by the way. Dave Campbell, it's got a Twitter page. Updates on Twitter. Forgot about that, actually. Let's see. Give us all the backing you can, hun. We want it back. Not just us in the Northeast, but everyone in the area is covered by Magic. We do. We do. I totally agree. I absolutely 100% agree with this, Maria. This, we've got to make a stand. We've got to make a stand about this. I'm going to still keep posting on Magic's your Magic page. You'll give us Magic 1152. I'm still going to continue to support you guys in there, because this support has been going so well, and everybody just said that it just sucks. Everybody just doesn't like it, because they don't like the new policy that was given out by Bull Media, and neither Bull Media, we were never told by Bull Media. We never told about media. Well, actually, nobody was ever told what was happening. And they're going to look on notices and say, policy is changing 2015, 5th of January, will be your music station. Sign your agreement here or get out and pack your bags and go. The first to go was Anna. Anna Foster went. She walked out. Actually, I think she decided to go, because she didn't like anything happening, the changes that happened. Who the hell is the new guy on the bloody mornings now? Get rid of him. Get rid of him. Please get rid of him. He's terrible. Jamie. Is it Jamie or something? Yeah. That's a brighten up your mornings where you go with hyperactive music, Ken. Ha, right? So where did that hire him from? Get him off. Then you had Dave Campbell. No, he didn't. You had Nick Wright. Nick Wright was... Nick Wright, I think, is the main cause of it all. That's what I think. He's the main cause of it all. I think he basically doesn't have... He doesn't have the energy to say... He didn't even have the balls to really... tell them. He decided, though. Nick Jackson at breakfast. Good he was. Imagine 52 Manchester lost the breakfast presenter Ian Roberts, who ran a competition on his show. Did all breakfast jock lose their jobs? They did. Anna Foster was to go. Everybody, in fact, on the morning staff went. Nick Jackson went. There was another guy in there as well. The Liverpool one, York, everybody went. They didn't want to do the new changes on it. I went on to Metro Radio's site today, website, and oh my god, have you seen the right arseholes on there? The new morning presenters on there. Good hell. Looked like they were in a bit of a hyperactive student side. Students who want to present on shows like that? Well, you tell me. I'm not a student. I present the show, but not a student, though. Stupid idiots. Let's have a look. Jean said, "What were they? When they were telling us about the change, it said that they were that all it was changing. Changing was the name, and the station would be bigger and better. That's what Nick was telling me. Nick was lying to us. Nick Wright was lying to us all. I'm telling you, he was, because he didn't tell me. He didn't email me exactly the truth itself." I think we're all being basically ripped off by this, what's going on. But I'm really wanting, if all of us get together, just go down, knock on their doors, press a button, and tell them. We stand up for our rights, we have our rights. We've got our consumer rights. We'll write a watchdog about it. Watchdog's the next thing you guys should do. Email watchdog at bbc.co.uk. Email those guys, tell them. Because tell them it's just a disgrace that they've done. Board media should be shocked what they've done as well. Everybody should have their own opinion about what they want on the station. And like I said, if no one listens to Magic anymore, if no one listens to Board Media's Your Music anymore, I'll start a radio station up. And believe me, we will get these guys back. Apart from, well, we'll get Dave Campbell back, but we'll get the other ones. But I'm willing to put my heart and soul back into this radio station to get it back on the air. Right, Dixie L. Right, carry on. These folk, the presenters, have... Nope. He did... Which was... Trying to... I'll just say from my point... Say tonight. Bring back Magic, and we'll otherwise prepare to go to Newcastle and tell them anyone was ridiculous. And do. For the next... And expect... Because this is just something to really struggle with the station without much, because the way it was great. So I need to change it to you got Magic Limb 52, because this is something that we are bring it back. Either keep it going strong, there, get it out. Do we keep? But like I say, said before, just because I being but if we'll see what should be about. The more this teenage... Where's the stuff like we if you got your original... Sorry, I can't follow this, because it seems a little bit weird because the just being a bit of an arse thing. And we'll come back in, as I say, and then we will get your point made as comments. Please leave them with... And I'll catch you guys on next...